Hey class, welcome back to the Geotech lab. In this week's video, we're going to be reviewing the specific gravity test of sand. So we're going to be determining the specific gravity of these soil specimens that we found from the ground surface that we use in our moisture content lab. Again, specific gravity is just the ratio of the density of the solid divided by the density of water. Since density of water is known, the density of solid can then be found, which is a really important property when it comes to the volumetric relationships and the phase diagrams and all that fun stuff. So we're going to be using what's called a pycnometer. It's this fancy little bulb-shaped glass that allows us to pull a vacuum and remove all the air bubbles from the soil specimen. Hope you guys enjoy this, and I hope it helps illustrate some of the background information or some of the background tests that are performed to get you the values that you use in your lecture class and that we'll ultimately use in geotechnical engineering design and foundation analysis. Okay, so let's review the materials that we need for this lab. As I mentioned earlier, we're going to be using the sand that was collected from the ground surface that we used in the moisture content lab last week. So the good thing about this is we require to use completely oven dry sand, so have a moisture content of zero. And since this was in the oven for last week's lab, we can verify that the sand is completely dry. So no mass of water in the void space at all. So we also need to use a number four sieve, and we haven't gone over what sieves are yet, but they're pretty much just filters that will filter out specific sizes of grains. So to do that, we need to filter the number four sieve, which means all particles greater than 4.75 millimeters in diameter are going to be filtered out. So that's these here. And we're not gonna be using these at all. So we can toss those out. And we have this sample that we're gonna be using. So we need water, preferably distilled water. We don't have distilled water, so we're using tap water. So that could be a source of error. Gonna need a little scoop to scoop our soil into our pycnometers. Again, this is a pycnometer. It's 500 milliliters if filled exactly to the top there. Don't know if you can see that. But there's a little white line at each one. And these are basically highly calibrated containers that when filled to that line with a standard temperature of 20 degrees Celsius, we know it will be exactly 500 milliliters. So you see we have three of them. We're going to do three tests and take the average of them just to reduce the amount of error. We're also going to have another standard beaker to take the temperature of water because we're going to have to correct the specific gravity for 20 degrees Celsius, and you'll see a chart in the procedures. We also have our little funnel to fill the sample. We also have our scales that we need, same as last time, with a precision to 0.01 gram. And then we also have our vacuum and shake table. Basically, we need vacuum lines to pull all the air out of the sample and remove all the air and get the sample 100% saturated. This little shake table will help us agitate it and make sure that all the voids are being released of air. And you'll see that here in like probably 2 minutes.
emptied and dried the flasks again and we're done with the calibration phase. We now need to put approximately 100 grams of our dry soil in each one of the flasks, and then we'll take the weight of each flask with the dry soil in it. So now we need to prepare the pycnometers for the vacuuming process. So again, the point of the vacuuming process is to remove all the air voids and to get the sample 100% saturated. Remember, soil is solid, air, and water. So if we remove the air portion and we just have solids and water, then that's 100% saturation. And we need that state for the calculation of the specific gravity value. So we will now fill these up about 2/3 of the way with water, and we don't have to be exact here, but the thing that we do have to look out for is to make sure all this sand and material within the stem or the neck of the pycnometer, we need all of that washed down and to have all the soil completely under water. So it'll be about 2/3. I'm using the water that we poured out of when during the calibration state, so this is going to be assumed to be the same temperature as before when we were taking the mass of them full. Okay, so this next step is a crucial one. We need to, again, get these soil samples completely saturated. We have 3 pycnometers, and what these pycnometers allow us to do is apply a vacuum to the top, so it will remove all the air bubbles. But again, we're not using distilled water, so there is going to be some entrained air in the water, but there's also impossible to remove all air voids in the sample. Usually you would have to have this running for a couple hours. We're only going to be doing it for about 5 minutes. And the shake table is not nearly as much agitation as you may need to remove all the air bubbles. But in order to run the vacuum, we're going to be needing one, the vacuum line here, and we're going to attach it all the way to our shake table here. So one of the potential sources of air that you should account for in this lab is the fact that we are unable to pull a full vacuum. You can see a full vacuum would be at -1 bar. We're only about at an 80% vacuum. Also, that's a vacuum at the source. This whole line, and especially our vacuum trap, has the potential to also lose a vacuum. So we may not be getting a full suction. In this case, normally you would see the soil, bubbles coming from the soil. In this case, I still think we're removing air, but it may not be a full vacuum. So that would mean the specific gravities may be a little off. So account for that in your reports. but we'll see what the final numbers are.
So now we've taken our pycnometers off of the shake table and out of the vacuum. Again, that whole process, we're going to be assuming that now there is no air entrapped within the void space of the soil. It's 100% saturated. So the next step we need to follow is to fill the water back up to that calibration line, that 500 milliliter calibration line. We'll do that for each pycnometer. We're going to be carefully pouring using our funnel and our water that we're assuming is staying at the same temperature. And once we get to the neck, we need to fill using the squirt bottle just so we can be precise and we're not adding any more entrained air to our mixture. Remember, assuming that it's 100% void of air, so no air in the voids. All right, well now make sure that the exterior is completely dry. We'll use just a paper towel to dry off the exterior and we'll take the weights of each one of these and then we would have all the values that we need to calculate our specific gravity. So remember, all three of these are the same material, so we will just take the average of each specific gravity calculated and that would be our assumed specific gravity for the sample of soil that we took from the ground surface at the project location from last week's lab.